This week, all eyes are on the COP28 climate conference and its oil-producing host, the UAE. Markets will also be weighing the significance of last week's OPEC Plus production cut announcement and admission of Brazil as a new member of the group from January. The cuts come against the backdrop of sagging oil prices, though financial markets anticipate interest rate pressures could start to ease, and a weaker dollar should support oil demand. Markets will also be monitoring developments in the Middle East after attacks on shipping over the weekend. In a sign of heightened risks to shipping and oil flows, the US Navy shut down several drones and cruise missiles launched from Yemen and vessels in the Red Sea, one of the world's most important choke points for crude tankers. European power markets will be tracking temperature and wind forecasts after a cold snap boosted prices in late November. French power is most at risk from the cold. Every degree centigrade drop in winter temperature pulls an extra 2 gigawatts of power onto the grid to help meet heating demand. Overall, the system is much better supplied compared to last December. But only 4 French nuclear reactors are scheduled to return this week, so France might have to import during peak demand periods. Norwegian gas exports remain a key focus for the European markets, with more than 350 million cubic meters now flowing daily. Norway is now the single biggest source of gas for Europe, so the market will be watching for any unplanned outages that could impact exports heading deeper into winter. I'm Vivian Irania. Thank you for kicking off your Monday with S&P Global Commodity Insights.